guys, so we just came back from the store. It was only an hour this time versus like 6 hours last video. So we got some things. We got vacuum hose. I think this will be the same. I should have probably checked it before I showed you guys, but I'll show you guys anyways. We got these brackets for the bottom of the intercooler to mount them from the bottom of the rest support. We're definitely gonna have to trim these and adjust these a little bit, but this is the best we could find for what we needed. We also got these bolts. These are like super long, and we're gonna use them anyways. And then we got two more things: the nuts for the bolts and
chain. we're gonna use this to temporarily secure the intercooler piping, just so it's not moving around too much. So this is our temporary fix.
What are we doing next?
So we're gonna be cutting that pipe. That pipe needs to be cut anyways. We're gonna see what we're gonna do about this one, see if the right piping, this piping, we could use it to mock the intercooler where we want it, so it clears the bumper. That's pretty much it. Let's get to work. So we trimmed these real quick, took about an inch off. Let's see how it fits. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, so we just went to the parts store. We just got back. I mean, we went to the parts store. Like, got my hands. I had gloves, but we had to go to my uncle's house to help him and help him put his swap in another car. And it was an hour, and now it's late, and we got to do this quickly. But after we went to the parts store, we did stop by, and I need a seat, so we can try to do it right now tonight. We're gonna try. Sorry for the wind noise, but here's the seats. Get the car done today and on the road to at least do a burnout, we're gonna be riding in these. So let's get right to it and we'll catch you guys after. So we got it all installed, so let me go over it with you. So we've made the brackets for the intercooler. You can tell the intercooler is kind of sitting back, so we will have to make one more bracket in the top to straighten it out. Intercooler piping's in nice and sturdy. Vacuum lines, I just got some whatever clear lines. I hope this holds. battery terminals back on, everything secured, because I think we're gonna try to do this burnout. At least start it. Let's start it and see how it goes and go from there. So he's gonna start it right now, see how she sounds. Alright guys, so now it's able to start. We just cranked a little bit. So we figured out it was the starter signal on the starter. It came out a little loose, I guess, when we were moving all that stuff around. So it cranks, but we're gonna see if it turns on for real. Go ahead, brother. Alright, so it starts. Hit it. You guys hear that blow off valve? All right, so it's open downpipe right now, so that's why it's so loud. Should we do the burnout? No? So I guess we're not gonna do the burnout, guys. He doesn't want to.
All right, guys, so where we ran into, it seems to be getting either fuel cut off or the boost getting cut off, but I mean, it's running, it's together.
The burnout wasn't the greatest. I tried to get it good, but I was having some sort of cutoff. I don't know if it was fuel or something, but it was cutting off whenever I full throttle this, so I couldn't really do a crazy burnout. Okay, it hooked good and you like kind of felt the tire spinning like the first or second time, but that's all I was able to do.
I could probably do a better burnout.
So what we're gonna do is, this is gonna be it for today. We're gonna fix everything. We're gonna cut everything up, mount the bumper again, and then next time we're gonna bun the whole turbo, figure out our issue, and then wire our headlights and kind of seal the deal with this car for now. Mm-hmm. So I think that's it. Back on, everything secured, because I think we're going to try to do this burnout. At least start it. Let's start it and see how it goes and go from there. So he's going to start it right now, see how she sounds.